Germany is one of America's most important allies, and nearly every American president since George W. Bush has worked closely with German Chancellor Angela Merkel. But for the first time since 2005, she will not be a candidate when Germans head to the polls this Sunday to vote for her successor. Special correspondent Malcolm Brabant is in Berlin with a preview of the upcoming election.
Judy, this is the end of an era. Angela Merkel is slipping away from the political stage with minimal fanfare, which is entirely consistent with her modest, understated style. She's leaving behind huge shoes to fill, and there's a very tight race to replace her as Chancellor.
For 16 years, Angela Merkel has led Germany and been Europe's most dominant politician. They call her Mutti or Mom. Now, as Mutti is leaving the Chancellery, Germany is out of its comfort zone.
I think she'll be remembered as a very important statesperson that kept Europe together.
Peter Neumann is a senior advisor to Merkel's centre-right Christian Democrat Party.
History will remember her as a successful chancellor, as a popular chancellor, as a chancellor that brought Germans a great deal of prosperity.
President Biden saluted the shy research scientist who became the first East German to assume her nation's highest office since reunification.
So wahr mir Gott helfe.
On behalf of the United States, thank you, Angela, for your career of a strong, principled leadership. And I want to thank you for your continued support for the long-standing goal of a Europe whole, free, and at peace.
In 2010, Merkel saved the euro currency by coordinating a financial bailout for Greece when it went bust. There were fears that other weak European economies would collapse and the euro would tank.
Europe fails when the euro fails. Europe wins when the euro wins.
Merkel's most controversial unilateral act was to throw open Germany's borders to Syrian refugees in 2015. In all, Germany granted asylum to over a million in that first year of Europe's migration crisis.
And I have to say quite honestly, if we now start having to apologize even for showing a friendly face in emergency situations, then this is not my country.
People across the developing world saw this as an invitation to enter Europe. Only Sweden emulated Germany. Partner nations resented being pressured. Hungary erected a border fence, wrecking the EU's commitment to open internal frontiers. 6 years on, the flow of asylum seekers into Europe is still strong. Sonia Skeets runs a London-based pro-refugee non-profit. She thinks Merkel was right.
Germany and Sweden tried to start a grown-up conversation with other European states, and other European states weren't willing to step up to the plate.
The influx caused a backlash at home, and as Peter Neumann explains, led to a resurgence of the far right in East Germany.
Significant parts of the electorate didn't like it at all, and especially the East, where she's coming from, was very aggrieved about it and still holds it against her. I think that's the point where she lost the former East Germany.
Since Merkel opened Germany's borders in 2015, European right-wingers like French presidential candidate Marine Le Pen have secured a stronger footing with their anti-immigration rhetoric.
All of the migrants who didn't stay in Germany went off amusing themselves in other European countries without asking for our permission. Those who didn't remain in Germany went to Sweden, Italy, and France, weighing heavily on our finances and creating conditions for conflict.
Unlike last time when immigration dominated, climate change is this election's hot issue. Polls suggest that Germany is steering to the left. Most Germans expect Social Democrat Olaf Scholz to replace Merkel. As finance minister in Merkel's coalition government, Scholz is a known quantity, if a little dull. His main rival, Armin Laschet, who replaced Merkel as head of the centre-right Christian Democrats, is also charisma-challenged. But that's not a disadvantage in Germany. The main outsider, Annalena Baerbock of the environmentalist Greens, is predicted to be kingmaker in the next inevitable coalition.
Many citizens can see me as the next head of government, the next chancellor. And I make no secret that above all, I would like to create a government in alliance with the Greens.
Laschet is promising Merkel-like stability.
I stand for the cohesion of Europe in these difficult times, a climate-neutral industry and a strong economy, and a clear course for national security.
Baerbock wants to force the Christian Democrats into opposition.
I stand for no longer using half measures to protect the climate, a policy that finally brings children and family to its core, and a human rights-led foreign policy in the heart of Europe.
Devastating floods caused by unnaturally heavy summer rain pushed climate change onto the election agenda. The death toll is still unclear, but could be as high as 300. Restoration could cost $30 billion. Activist Jakob Heinsen has gone without food for 3 weeks to highlight climate change. At the hunger strikers' camp, spokeswoman Helen Lubert had harsh words for the Greens.
They're not the solution. Even their program is not enough. And therefore, I think it's important that they're part of a coalition. They do everything they can within the political spectrum, within the parliament. And then we also definitely need opposition from without the parliament.
Facing possible defeat, centre-right parliamentary candidate Klaus-Dieter Gröhle was trying to woo voters with bratwurst and beer.
People are asking critical questions, but I'm not getting the sense that they are really interested in a change of government.
That's not what the polls say. This voter won't be swayed by a sausage.
Angela Merkel did a good job overall, but we need to do something different.
As election day approaches, the party of Angela Merkel is hoping Germans will avoid change and play safe, as they have done so often in the past. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Berlin.